Good morning from Tuskegee National Forest. We're gonna get set up and I'm gonna give it a go with a throw line again. A lot of people give me tips when I shared how much I hate using a Endfedz half wave or Endfedz antenna in general or wire antenna or whatever. So I'm gonna give it another go. So I brought today the PAR Endfedz trail friendly 40-20-10, I believe is the three bands that it works on. So we're gonna give this antenna a go. And I've used this antenna a lot at home. So I actually have this set up as my main base station antenna for probably a year. And had great results with it. It actually performs a lot better than you would expect. So let's set it up and see how it does here in the field. Now I've chosen a location with a very nice easy branch right there that I should be able to nail no problem. And then I'm gonna set up right here. So stand by and I'm gonna get this antenna set up. Alright, so now that we've got the antenna set up, which that worked fantastic, honestly. Thank you to the folks who gave me that tip to swing it between my legs and then let go and let it go over the limb. That actually worked and got it on the second try. The first time it got caught on my pocket knife, so pulled my knife out of my pocket instead of going up into the tree. But antenna is hung and worked a lot better than I expected it to. So. Again, thanks for that tip. So let's get the rest of everything set up. I did want to show you my new POTA accessory. I ordered this little table right here off of Amazon for like 40 bucks. And it's just a small folding table, but it lets me set up places that do not have picnic tables, which is most of the areas that I like to do parks on the air. A lot of times I do use this little side table down here on my chair, and that works good for me, but it's hard to get a good camera angle where you guys can see what I'm writing. So when I'm recording videos, I really need a flat writing surface like a table. So I bought this and hopefully that will help. So let's set up the radio. Today we're going to use the Lab 599 and get on the air and see how many contacts we can make today. So I must apologize. I somehow messed up the settings on my camera and I lost the audio from the camera during the activation. So you won't be able to hear me speaking in real time during the activation, but you will be able to hear the audio from the radio nice and clear. So you'll still be able to follow along in the activation and I will try to do voiceovers where appropriate. So I appreciate you watching. Thank you.
Thank you.
So that was a good run on 40 meters this morning. Band conditions were behaving, the antenna performed nicely, the radio, everything just lined up, and had back-to-back contacts for a good little while here. Jump back in here in just a second and make some more contacts. Very awkward narrating this after the fact, but I'm trying to do that anyway. I was happy with this activation. It was fun.
Yep. So, oh, he picks up the pen. He puts it down towards the paper. He flips the page back one. What is he doing? Is he going to write? Oh, he's going to write a 12 and an 11. Looks like he is adding clarification to the time to make sure he logs correctly. His hand goes near the key, but he moves it to the left just a little bit, moves the radio, adjusts the volume, and it looks like he's about to get back on the air. Is he? Here he goes. Oh, nope. Put the pen down. Okay, here we go. Buddy hesitates again. What is he doing? Okay, here we go. Thank you. Alright, so here I'm just adding some headers for the top row of this page, since I had to add another page for my log. And then count my contacts to see if I want to keep going or not, because getting to where I need to start heading back home. But I count my contacts and then decide that I want to keep going for just a little bit, and I want to try to get to 30. Thank you. And that is where I call it a day. So that was a great activation on 40 meters. Really happy with how the antenna performed. Appreciate again everyone that gave tips. The swinging between the legs method really did work. So I guess Endfedz half wave or wire antennas in the field are an option for me now. So thank you for sharing your tips. That was very useful. So I appreciate you watching this video. I appreciate you subscribing, liking, commenting, and getting to know each of you and answering any questions that you have. Feel free to drop them in the comments, shoot me an email. Happy to talk to anybody, and I appreciate you watching. So we'll catch you in the next video from W4ARB. And the next one will not be narrated so awkwardly unless I screw up the camera settings again, which is possible.